Do you drive better than the average person? Are you a great driver? Hi, welcome to another episode of Unlocking the Mind Behind Make More Work Less. My name is Fong Chua. I'm an entrepreneur, business strategist, real estate investor, speaker, and also a best-selling author. And every single day, I help others unlock potentials and guide them to succeed. Today on Unlocking the Mind, we talk about another cognitive bias. And the reason why I have this show is so that we can better understand how our minds work, make better decisions, build stronger relationships, and of course, avoid certain cognitive traps. So for today's cognitive bias, I ask you a question. Are you better than the average driver? Most of you probably put your hands up. Most of you probably said, yes, I am better than the average driver. So why did you say that? If the average should be 50, I'm sure a lot of people here actually said, yes, they're a better driver. Well, that's because we all experience the illusory superiority. What exactly is that? Well, it's when a person overestimates their own qualities and their own abilities in relation to other people's qualities and those same abilities as well. So when I said, are you a better driver? Most of you probably said yes. And this study, this question has been asked for many, many years, many, many times, many, many different locations. And more likely than not, people say, yes, I'm a better driver than most people. In fact, over 80% of the people will usually say, they're a better driver than the average person. So how is that possible if average is 50%? That's because of this superiority complex. We tend to like to feed our egos. We like to generally think that we're confident in what we do and what we think we do well. And it allows us to actually have that confidence to do different things, to jump out of our comfort zones, to take on risks, to seek opportunities. Without this illusory superiority, we would actually stop doing anything and be scared and be stuck in our own rut and not venture out and try new things. So actually, this illusory superiority is very important in our development and in order for us to improve as human beings. If without it, we get stuck. Now, the thing is, with it, sometimes you have to take a step back and go, are we way overconfident? Are we way in over our heads? We need to go and ask other people's thought processes so that we are protecting ourselves to not fall prey to this illusory superiority. So that is how we can avoid it, so that we can bounce those ideas off of each other and make sure that we have everything taken care of, we have all the risks taken care of, and that we're not just overconfident. This is very, very close to the Dunning-Kruger effect, where people are way, way confident knowing just a little bit of information. And the thing is, after a period of time, they tend to lose that confidence because they realize how much more they didn't even know. So the thing is, that overconfidence is that illusory superiority. We can't fall prey to it, but without it, we won't grow. We won't seek different things. We won't jump out of our comfort zones. Just think, it's because of that illusory superiority that allows people to jump out and start their own business, to jump out and speak on stage, to jump out of an airplane and go skydiving, because we have that overconfidence. We have that sense of ego that we can do this. We can do this better than other people. Even if businesses usually fail within X amount of years, you have that thought process that goes, you know what, I'm better than those people, I won't fail. And that's why you venture into a business venture. So that illusory superiority is very important for us to actually go out and try new things. But don't let that superiority stop us from asking other people for help, or stop us from reassessing our situation or reassessing our risk. We can't let overconfidence or overego to cause us to fail. So make sure you have that group of people that you can bounce ideas off of. Make sure you do some good evaluations on your risks, but don't let that superiority stop you from venturing out and trying new things. So that is the illusory superiority. I hope you enjoyed this episode. And if you did, please go back and watch some of my other episodes on Unlocking Mind. And of course, there are a lot of other shows, the Peak Potential Success Show, the Master Mind Bites, and of course, the Make More Mind Bites that's up every single week. So until next time, thank you very much for your support, your likes, your subscriptions, and your comments. I love seeing those comments. And until next time, today is the day to lock your peak potential. I'll see you later.